Hydrogen has been heralded as the fuel of the future before and will continue to be so in the future. In 1806, it powered the first internal combustion engine to run on gasoline. Carbon dioxide from fossil fuels is mostly used in the chemical and refining sectors to make hydrogen today. Its yearly CO2 emissions are 830 million metric tons, which is the same as the combined emissions of the United Kingdom and Indonesia combined. While green hydrogen will reduce pollution, many old issues remain, the most pressing of which is how to securely store it. Hydrogen storage currently necessitates extremely high pressure, making it prohibitively expensive and inefficient for broad usage in automobiles. However, what if we could cheaply store hydrogen as a solid? A startup company has finally found the solution to the hydrogen storage problem. Heavy-duty e-mobility applications such as buses, vehicles, trains, and ships rely heavily on hydrogen. This is because these large-scale vehicles demand a lot of energy that batteries can't supply today. As long as you have access to hydrogen, a fuel cell doesn't need to be recharged like a battery. When compared to batteries, fuel cell electric vehicles, FCEVs, have a higher driving range and a shorter refilling time. As a result, hydrogen is an excellent fuel for long-distance travel. However, there is still an issue. How can you safely and economically store a large amount of hydrogen on board? In order to safely store hydrogen as a gas, high-pressure containers must be used, which are expensive and difficult to maintain. You could also compress it and transform it into a liquid. However, hydrogen boils at minus 252.8 degrees Celsius, minus 423 degrees Fahrenheit. So if you want to preserve it in a liquid state, you'll have to cool it down and put it in a cryogenic tank, which is costly to maintain. When compared to storing a liquid molecule, solid storage of single atoms would pack more hydrogen into a smaller space. Furthermore, because this method does not require high pressure or cold temperatures, it is more cost-effective. Hydrogen-powered electric vehicles might even compete with gasoline-powered automobiles, and perhaps even battery-powered electric vehicles, thanks to this low-cost method of boosting their range. Many studies have been conducted on solid-state hydrogen storage applications because of this. Normally, there are two ways to attach hydrogen to a metallic complex. This is the process of hydrogen molecules or individual atoms adsorbing onto solid surfaces. The adsorbent is a term for that surface. Absorption is still another possibility. Absorbents are able to attach hydrogen to their internal structure in this way. You get what's known as a metal hydride in both circumstances. Plasma Kinetics, a new company, has come up with an alternative approach. This is a three-pronged zero-carbon system that does various jobs: capture, storage, and transport, according to their website. According to them, this new technology offers a greater energy capacity and lower cost than lithium-ion batteries. The recharge time is about 5 minutes. Using a light-activated nanoscale sheet that is 10 times thinner than a human hair, the company claims to have captured hydrogen from the air. This hydrogen sponge may trap gas at low temperatures and pressures, resulting in a lower overall cost for the consumer or business. Then all you have to do is shine a light on the film to get some hydrogen out. Isn't that a bit simplistic? Their project, on the other hand, is so brilliant that it was banned. However, let's take a closer look at this new technology. It's important to know the origin of this concept first. During a presentation to the US Department of Energy in 2009, Plasma Kinetics revealed their light-activated energy storage, LAES, technology, which was first described as transformative. Then, after some time, they changed their minds and began to refer to it as disruptive. Their invention, it appears, supplies an energy source that is protected by US national security. As a result, the US government put a hold on Plasma Kinetics' patent until 2017, slowing their progress. So what's the big deal about it? In order to capture hydrogen at atmospheric pressure and ambient temperature, Plasma Kinetics has developed a nanophotonic filter. The system could harvest 99.99% pure hydrogen directly from smokestacks and gas streams and solidify it in metric tons per day. How realistic do you think it is to implement this? The material selection appears to be key in this unusual creation. One definition of SMA is that it's an alloy that retains its shape even after it has been reshaped. Molding this material at a low temperature and then heating it to restore it to its former form is typical. SMAs, despite their resemblance to plastic, are really made of nickel and titanium alloys. Mechanical actuators and medical stents are two major SMA applications. You may find magnesium in Plasma Kinetics SMA. This alkaline earth metal is also a key component of chlorophyll, the photosynthetic pigment utilized by plants. That is why the substance used by the company interacts with light. When comparing light-activated hydrides to ordinary metal hydrides, this feature is the most important distinction. The second type of material uses reversible absorption to connect hydrogen atoms to their solid framework. However, it must be released at temperatures of up to 200 degrees Celsius, 392 degrees Fahrenheit. The company has referred to its products as either a DVD player or a CD projector, and according to the company, to liberate the mean trapped hydrogen in a cassette, canister, or disc, simply beam a laser light on the hydrogen-filled material. Does that sound like something out of a sci-fi movie? Exactly how does it actually operate, or should we say, how is it claimed to work? During the absorption cycle, negatively charged spots within the film's nanospores absorb positively charged hydrogen atoms. When a laser strikes the film, the light changes the polarity of the link from negative to positive, releasing the hydrogen atoms. That's the key advantage of their system. Unlike traditional metal hydrides, it doesn't heat up the material during the desorption process. Hydrogen is currently produced through energy-intensive and high-carbon technologies such as natural gas reforming or electrolysis. As a result, Plasma Kinetics' zero-carbon capture technique might have a significant environmental impact on hydrogen generation, that is, assuming it even works at all. While hydrogen-powered passenger cars are unlikely to catch on in the same way as battery-powered vehicles have, the way this technology is expected to function is that you buy a hydrogen-filled disc cartridge from a convenience store. It does not necessitate particular safety storage such as hydrogen gas canisters. When a hydrogen-filled disc cartridge runs out, you simply take it back and exchange it for a new one. It is said that it would only take a few minutes to replace the cartridges in the vehicle. The decarbonization of energy grids is another big market segment. That's because, according to Plasma Kinetics, this gadget can make green hydrogen even greener. Hydrogen produced through electrolysis driven by renewable sources will be stored in the company's storage facility. Compression or liquefaction is not necessary for the storage of some of the green hydrogen. In order to generate green electricity, you can feed the clean hydrogen into fuel cells. On overcast days or when the wind doesn't blow, this would fill the gaps in the clean power supply, making our renewables-based grid more adaptable and resilient. A wind farm is an example of a location where the film-containing canisters could be erected. Low-cost backup storage for rural communities or mobile microgrids for rescue operations could be provided by these devices. The capture and storage of hydrogen seems very promising, but what about the distribution of hydrogen? According to the company's pitch deck, they can securely transport 20,000 tons of hydrogen on a single ship by loading their containers one at a time. That's enough to power 25,000 homes for a year in terms of energy. However, how does their hydrogen storage invention stand up to its rivals? The light-activated hydrides appear to overshadow the lithium-ion batteries in every way. While lithium-ion batteries offer the same amount of energy storage, Plasma Kinetics claims that its technology is 17% less expensive and 30% lighter than lithium-ion batteries. The light-activated storage unit, on the other hand, is believed to have an efficiency of up to 70%, which is slightly lower than high-capacity batteries, which have an efficiency of between 70 and 90%. Furthermore, while Plasma Kinetics' system has a lower energy density than highly pressured storage, its materials are reported to be less expensive. Using one of their light-activated hydrogen trucks instead of a compressed hydrogen-powered vehicle, according to company calculations, would save 20,000 euros per year in fuel expenditures. This is because the cost of solid-state hydrogen per kilowatt-hour is half that of compressed hydrogen. Plasma Kinetics' solid-state hydrogen system appears to be too good to be true, but only time will tell if they can make it work or if their bluff remains intact. So what are your thoughts on this idea of solid hydrogen storage? Let's have them in the comments section.